We took part of a mystery movie screening. And I want to talk about that first. It's actually an interesting marketing strategy, I think, for a film. It does have its pros and cons. Like, if you're going to watch a movie and alam na naman natin yung mystery box, but there's like a risk or there's like this parang uneasy feeling at times when you open up something. So when you're gonna watch something and you don't know what's going to be showing, it's actually a bit nerve-wracking, to be honest. For example, you're not a fan of a horror movie and then you go in and then it's a horror movie, so it's actually disappointing, right? But I was actually pleased of what I saw last night because it was an advanced screening of Gran Turismo, which will actually be released at the end of the month here in the Philippines, but we got the chance to actually watch it. And that's the topic of this particular movie review. Gran Turismo is a part of PlayStation and Sony's properties. Doesn't feel like a video game adaptation. It's first and foremost based on real life events.
You really think you're gonna take a kid who plays video games in their bedroom, you're gonna strap them to a 200 mile an hour rocket? It'll tear them to pieces.
In itself, that gives it a space that it doesn't really have to live up to create, number one, a story based off of Gran Turismo, and it doesn't replicate something like The Last of Us or other video games. I love that this feels more like a sports drama, inspirational kind of movie like Coach Carter. Is it in that level? Not necessarily, but I love the intensity. I love the way it captures something so real and inspirational and powerful. There's so many themes on family, on dreams, your aspirations. Really, at the heart and soul of this movie is a kid who just really wanted to be a racer despite people around him saying that he couldn't and that it's impossible. It's a difficult dream to accomplish, but then he goes out for it. And in a way, it's a good message. It's a nice message packed with lots of action. My biggest tension about this is it doesn't also feel like completely like any racing film we've seen in the past. It's not all like Ford versus Ferrari. It's also not something along the lines of Fast and the Furious. It has its own lane, no pun intended. It has its own direction that it zeroes in on, which does combine like that sports kind of inspirational movie and racing. I love the thrilling aspect of this because there are moments that this film is very at the edge of your seat, full of suspense. There is a predictability to it. There are moments that you can figure out what the flow of the story is. There's nothing too out of the line or out of the box that becomes like a surprising moment. There are like cliches and things that you would actually expect, but I didn't necessarily feel like it was totally a bad thing. I love also a bit of the visual treatments. Again, it does, however, tend to be a bit pushed to its limits. There are moments that they have animated styles to him playing or him in the game mode. So there were elements of the game. There were elements of Gran Turismo, which was very much appreciated, but then at times they do it too much. And in a way, it was nice to have those elements that go back to the game, that reference the game. And I think that's something that you would enjoy. But at the end of it all, I don't necessarily feel like this was a Gran Turismo kind of movie. I mean, it can be named or titled something else and get away with it. I mean, the story in a way refers to this kid who plays that game, but then strip that part out and it's just a normal, you know, like underdog story. And that's what you pretty much get. It's a bit tropish. It's a bit, again, something familiar, but it's something exciting still. I love particularly here David Harbour. I mean, he was like the standout here. If you want to cast someone who is so inspirational, who is someone who will motivate you but seem douchey at times, this is the guy you get. He plays David Harbour, I feel. Like, it's David Harbour as David Harbour. It's him. But there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, there's nothing wrong with getting that sarcastic, like, guy and at the same time, in a way, transform and develop, because there is like this grittiness to him but an emotional aspect to his character which he delivers on as well. So there was really nice elements happening in this movie that combined to make a nice exciting film. So I give this film a grade of 8 out of 10. It accomplishes its goal of being entertaining, being fun and exciting, and that's pretty much what you want out of a movie, especially if you're gonna watch a mystery movie like this and not know kung ano yung mapapanood mo. I was very much happy with what we got. So definitely check out Gran Turismo when it drops at the end of the month, August 30 here in the Philippines. That's pretty much it for this video. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. Make every day into an adventure and stay safe, guys.